Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Thanks for joining me today. I'm talking smile lines, nasolabial folds. Still a top driver to practices of patients complaining of an aged look because of those folds. This is where fillers and products were approved for over 30 years now, because people look in the mirror, they see the folds of aging. And I get it, I can understand why. Part of the problem I see is people are sending people watching YouTube down the very wrong road by saying certain treatments are going to fix that problem. Today I'm going to tell you six treatments that do not work for nasolabial folds. Then I'm going to show you three that do. And at the end, I'll give you a bonus little tip of something you can do at home as well to help remove the appearance of those lines. Now, to understand it fully, you have to understand the complexity, and I'll tell you why they occur. Number one is bone. There's bone loss in the maxilla, or the bone here, that when it resorbs, it makes that a little bit deeper. Number two is muscle pull. A lot of times, young people, they have them when they smile, but not at rest. As we age, the muscle pulls a little bit more. In fact, there's evidence that the muscle in the face actually pulls on the bone and creates some of the bony changes that we see. I'll talk about facial exercises. If you guys want, let me know in the comments below, because I think that's important. But there, I did sit through an hour lecture just recently, very fascinating, how the muscles pull the bone, but they play a role for those nasolabial folds for sure. Third is the fat pad. So we have a malar fat pad. A lot of people know that name because it creates a problem in the midface. But the fat pad, we know now, hypertrophy, so it grows, and it grows right at the edge where you don't want it to, and it almost creates a fold there. And when I talk about some treatments that don't work, this will make a lot of sense. So that's the fat pad plays an important role in the growth of that. Along with the muscle pull, I said the muscle pulls for the younger person, but they don't see it. Collagen loss. As we age, the muscle pulls, you get the bone loss, you get the collagen loss, and the fat pad growth, and that all adds up to an aging feature. So now, let's go through the six things that will not fix your folds that you've led to believe maybe they will. If you like the videos, click like, subscribe, and definitely comment. Let me know what you want to see coming up. But I want to make sure that you get the education so that you do the treatments that are right for you to save you time, money, and energy. Number one treatment that's not going to work are facial exercises for this fold. So you can do all the exercises you want. I'd love to see the before and after picture of 1, 3, 4, 5 months, whatever it takes, of facial exercises that's going to get rid of that fold. Number two is microneedling. Microneedling, whether you're putting in a retinol, a hyaluronic acid, platelet-rich fibrin like I do, it will not remove that fold. You won't get enough collagen building to create that lift, create bone, or reduce the fat that's creating it. Number three, Kybella, or fat-dissolving PCDC, phosphatidylcholine, or deoxycholate injections. The reason we don't use them, you might think we would because there's a fat pad, reduce the fat, well, everything will be good. The problem is it also gets rid of the myelin or the covering around the nerve. You'll end up with a little palsy or a stroke-like look too often than not, so we don't use it. Number four, retinol. You can use all the retinol you want in the world. It's not going to get rid of a nasolabial fold for you. It's not its function. It can help build collagen, give you better skin, but it's not going to get rid of that fold. Number five is LED masks. I did a whole review on them. I like them a lot, but they're not going to get rid of a fold. They do other things, as mentioned in that video, and they help with skin and possibly some collagen production, and they give a nice look, and they have positive benefits, but they will not get rid of a fold. The last one can help a little bit depending on what you're using, but I was talking more towards galvanic currents or microcurrents. Some people might use RF at home, And that collagen building can do something. So that's a soft call. Depends on the device you're using or the type, energy of microcurrent, if it produces heat and how strong it is. There are so many devices out there, but a lot of the ones that people are buying aren't strong enough to stop that fold. Let's go into the three things that will work and then my bonus tip that you can do at home as well. Number three is moving the tissues or reopposing the tissues. This is probably the most aggressive one, but a lot of people want to know about it now because it's accessible to them, and it's PDO threads and thread lifting. Not the smooth threads, although you could put them in the fold, and that will help get rid of the fold, but the barb or the lifting threads that you can see here that I put in with a large gauge cannula, and again, this is very accessible to so many people now. It's probably the most or the fastest growing minimally invasive procedure around the globe, certainly in North America, that I'm seeing today. One of the hottest trending topics. You put the thread in, you set the thread, you reoppose those fat layers so you actually do get a lifting effect. And now with the molded threads that we're using, the lift is pretty amazing. And you can put several threads in a face to get the lift that you want if the fat pad is deeper. My number three treatment is deep heating. Whether you're using RF, radio frequency devices, high frequency ultrasound, those are the two most common. And there's various devices that one can use to denature the collagens and get more structure and support deeper down. High frequency ultrasound, a lot of people know Ulthera, radio frequency thermage. I use a Viora device. There are many on the market. The key is the depth of the heating, the amount of heating, meaning the time and the energy. You have to heat the temperature at the correct amount for the correct time with each device, and they'll all be a little bit different depending on how much heat they produce. Because if you can get rid of fat, which of course we want in this region, so you can target it to remove fat and to build collagen to lift and tighten the tissues above it. So the provider is one of the most important factors for these type of treatments, because they will adjust the device in the area to do what you want to remove and tighten where appropriate, because it could go wrong. You could remove the fat where you don't want it to, and I know many of you have had that experience on my channel, many subscribers, and that's unfortunate because it does shrink the fat cell. Often doesn't permanently get rid of it, such as RF microneedling will with 67 degree temperatures, or dissolving fat with the injections like the PCDC Kybella type. Those are permanent fat reductions. So the heating usually makes the fat cells leaky as opposed to permanently get rid of them. So often that fat does return. Used correctly, that's a solid option number two, especially for those that don't want anything aggressive like threads, or fillers placed in, which is my number one most common, which is filling the folds, when that is by using hyaluronic acid filler. I will often use PlasmaSculpt or Sculptor type biostimulators because it's nice and smooth, but filling the folds directly, a hyaluronic acid is a really good choice because it's long lasting. It doesn't migrate here so much if done appropriately. You can use a micro cannula, so it's safer in some instances. And now we have nice flexible products that integrate with the tissues and move with the face. A bonus little tip here, if you're filling these folds, most people need mid-face fillers as well. The high cheek won't lift here as much, but the mid-face filler will help lift that nasal fold, and it can be placed in different layers, in the fat and on the bone, to reproduce what's the bone loss and what the fat loss is. If you're interested in learning more on injections, certainly consider, if you're a professional, joining my monthly membership at the Aesthetic Monthly Insider Training at aesthetictrainingcenter.com. But I wanted to give the concept to most people about the fillers. Now, what's my bonus tip that you can do at home that I actually think works really well for those who aren't ready for more aggressive treatments or if you've had more aggressive treatments done and you want to maintain. And it's really important to do so because the less you can get injected, the less invasive treatments you have done, the happier everyone is, the better it is, and the safer it is for you. So I believe hydrating the skin actually does work. By using a skincare product such as hyaluronic acid, which has small and larger molecules, so you get the penetration, and by hydrating that fold and attracting water, it plumps the area. A step further from that would be using mesotherapy, or an injection technique where you put little non-cross-linked hyaluronic acid blebs in the skin, so that can hydrate, help build collagen. Of course, hyaluronic acid not only attracts water but has antioxidant properties. But in a topical form, for those who wish to, if you do that on a regular basis, I think it actually works well. Prior, I said, yeah, retinol doesn't work. That's something absolutely different in terms of building collagen, but plumping the area can have a nice effect. And if it's a minimal to moderate fold, that's a great option to treat it topically. Do your nasolabial folds bother you? What's your best solution? I put a complete playlist up here of things you can do at home to help your skin, bone, and fat pads to maintain your skin to keep it beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.